If you have a brand new Core Ultra processor, did you know there's a one-button solution to make sure it's running faster? It's a one-click option in your BIOS that boosts not only CPU performance, but also your RAM performance as well. And it's doing all this without you having to know anything about tuning PCs. The best part is, it does all this without voiding your warranty also. Now we're gonna give you a guide on how to turn this on for every motherboard brand, talk about performance uplift and more, right here, right now on Robeytech. Now, this is gonna be a little bit of a different video, obviously, with how we're set up, but at Computex, as part of our paid coverage with Intel, I did a video with Robert Halleck, who runs the Intel channel business, and we talked about Intel Core Ultra 200S Boost. Essentially, it's a one-button option on all Intel Z890 boards that overclocks, for lack of a better term, components on your PC that can help boost performance as much as 16%. His claim is that it does this without changing clock speeds, but in fact, it changes things like fabric timings, RAM timings, and more to essentially get this free performance. And the reason that Intel has found this is because they have tons of data from all these different motherboard manufacturers that showed that they had this performance that they could unlock for everybody. Now, of course, on paper and coming from the mouth of an executive, it sounded good. And at the time of recording that video, I was actually surprised and hadn't tested it. And of course, I was itching to actually see if it worked myself. Now, funny enough, with the Computex video in edit, during our live stream build of the Lee & Lee LandCool 217, I installed an Intel Core Ultra 265K inside of an ASUS Strix Z890 motherboard myself. And I figured, you know what, during this live stream, this would be a great opportunity to see if what Robert was claiming was actually true. And color me a little bit surprised when we saw the Cinebench score jump from a 31806 to a 34430. That was a jump of over 2,500 points, which was almost a 10% jump in performance. So it went from words out of Robert's mouth to myself and 10,000 people seeing a live demo of it actually giving tangible results. And this is all from a PC part picker build that I had actually built out of happenstance. Now, the last bit of backstory before I jump into the guide is that the comments in both the LandCool 217 live stream and also off of the pre-mentioned video is that the performance is actually RAM dependent. And again, I'm learning about this at the time of recording this video, with one user claiming it's better with above 8,000 megatransfer RAM and another claiming it's worse with above 8,000 megatransfer RAM. And all of that brought me to today's video. So here is what's gonna happen today. And it's been a long week of testing. But what I'm gonna do is walk you through how to actually enable Core 200S Boost on ASRock, ASUS, Gigabyte, / AORUS, and MSI motherboards. And afterwards, I'm gonna show you some light testing that we did, which still took way more time than I thought it would, on both 6400 megatransfer RAM and 8400 megatransfer RAM to see if it does indeed make performance better or worse, and if we saw uplift across all motherboard brands in both gaming and Cinebench. Okay, so let's start off with the most important bit. First, in order to actually use Core 200S Boost, you need to ensure your motherboard BIOS is actually completely up to date. And remember, you have to do this on a Z890 motherboard. Okay, so let's start with ASRock. When you restart your computer, simply spam the delete or F2 key as it boots up and you will be in the BIOS screen like you're kind of seeing here. So from this screen that you're seeing here in the BIOS, what you're gonna do is you're gonna hit F6 to go to advanced mode. Now you're gonna scroll over to OC Tweaker. You can select either Profile 1 or Profile 2, both work. One is for 6400 or 6600. It's gonna be dependent on the RAM you have. Select a profile, hit F10, and hit save and restart. Now let your system restart, which could take some additional time, so be patient, and then boom, you're essentially good to go. So now, and this is only kind of for ASRock because you can select multiple profiles, what you're gonna do is when you get into Windows, go ahead and right-click on the taskbar and hit the Task Manager. Then select Performance, then select Memory, and then from there you can actually see the speed of the RAM, and then again, you can choose between the two profile options and then basically run Cinebench to see which one gets you the best performance, and then you're good to go there. All right, so now let's pop over to ASUS. Same thing, restart your system and enter the BIOS using your favorite method. Okay, so now from the main screen, go ahead and hit F7 to go into advanced mode. What you're gonna do now is pop over to AI Tweaker. You'll basically see an Intel 200S Boost item. Select the dropdown and change it to Enable. Click OK at the dialog menu. Hit F10 to save changes and reset. And then from here, let your system restart, which could, again, take you some additional time, so be patient. And then boom, you're essentially good to go. Okay, now for AORUS / Gigabyte. Again, restart your system and enter the BIOS using your favorite method. Now from the main screen here, at the very bottom, you're gonna basically see an Intel 200S Boost toggle. Now you're just gonna simply toggle that on. Click OK at the dialog menu, KitF10 to save changes and reset. And then from here, let your system restart, which could take some additional time, so be patient. And then boom, essentially you're good to go. Now, finally, MSI, same thing here too. Restart your system and enter the BIOS using your favorite method. Right down at the bottom, you'll see an Intel 200S boost toggle. Okay, what we're gonna do now is you're gonna go ahead and toggle it on. And then from this, you're basically going to click okay at the dialog menu, hit F10 to save changes, reset, and then okay. Just let your system restart, and then boom, you're essentially good to go. And there you go. That's a guide to each and every motherboard manufacturer for how to enable Core Ultra 200S Boost. Now remember, you do need to have, again, a Z890 motherboard in order to use 200S Boost. And if you don't see this option, you also need to make sure that you have XMP memory, not Expo memory, because if your memory is not compliant, you will not see this option. Okay, so now with Core 200S Boost enabled, let's take a look at some of the performance data. Now for this video, we basically use the Intel Core Ultra 285K. Now for the motherboards, we use the following boards in our test. We use the Z890 ASRock Live Mixer. We have the Z890 AORUS Elite Wi-Fi 7 Ice. We have the Z890 ASUS Tough Gaming Pro Wi-Fi, and finally a Z890 MSI MAG Tomahawk Wi-Fi. Now for the OS drive, we used a 2TB Kingston NV3 Gen 4 NVMe, running the latest and most up-to-date version of Windows 11. And for a gaming drive, we used a 2TB Kingston Fury Gen 4 NVMe that's just holding Cyberpunk 2077. Now for the cooler, we used the Li & Li Galahad 2 Lite 360mm AIO and a 1000W Thermaltake PSU. And finally, we used the NVIDIA RTX 5070 FE, running at 1440p, given this is a more realistic resolution for a modern PC using a Core Ultra CPU, and the workload is distributed more evenly across the CPU and the GPU. I mean, as much fun as 1080p is for CPUs, let's be honest, it's a dying resolution. Tests were 3 run averages of Cinebench R23, 10-minute benchmark, and we ran 3 runs of Cyberpunk 2077's benchmark. No other changes were made to the BIOS. It was the default that was basically set after restarting. The only thing I would say is MSI, we had to choose the Intel default because it was a forced selection. And then for XMP, we turned it on to get 6400 mega transfer and 8400 mega transfer without 200S boost. And then the Core 200S boost using the methods we showed in the guide up above. So now for the numbers, starting with 6400 mega transfer RAM. On ASRock, ASUS, and Gigabyte, we all saw an uplift from Cinebench, with Gigabyte showing the largest jump of over 1,000 points. As for gaming, we did see uplift around 2 FPS at 1440p on ASRock and Gigabyte, and a very tiny uplift of about a half a frame per second on ASUS. And again, this was across a 3-run average, so we did see that consistently. MSI, we actually saw performance degrade with Core 200S Boost, and we verified this on one more motherboard, the Z890 Edge Ti. However, when we did try it on another motherboard, the Z890 Gaming Plus Wi-Fi, we saw an increase in performance, jumping from 41,356 to 42,168. We've shared this data with MSI and with Intel, given the additional testing on ASUS. The Strix Z890 also showed an uplift, so this seems to be specifically an MSI issue. So unfortunately, it seems kind of inconsistent with MSI, and we'll put their official response down in the comments below if we get one from them. But what about 8,000 plus mega transfer RAM? Does performance actually get better, or does it get worse with faster RAM? Well, the story is the same here as it was with the 6400 mega transfer RAM. For ASRock, Gigabyte, and ASUS, in all the cases, enabling Core Ultra 200S Boost, even with the downclock of the RAM from 8400 to 8000, we did see an actual uplift in performance, but with much smaller gains. We also did see a similar uplift to what we saw in the previous testing on Cyberpunk 2077 across the 3 brands, with a slight uplift of 2 FPS across the board, except of course in ASUS, which again ended up being about half a frame, which is good to see. It's consistent both with 6400 and 8000 plus mega transfer RAM. For MSI, we saw a 400 point drop in performance. So it looks like in all cases, unless you have an MSI motherboard, of course, due to the inconsistency, turning on Core Ultra 200S Boost seems to be a win. Now, of course, your mileage may vary due to your individual components, silicon lottery, and all that sort of stuff, but all in all, you can just turn it on for free performance. It's also worth noting, based on some of the testing and data we've seen, and I'd love to get your thoughts on this, that if you went from 6400 mega transfer to 8000 mega transfer RAM based on the very limited testing set, it doesn't seem to be the biggest of jumps in performance. And in one case, the base Cinebench score on the ASUS motherboard was actually lower for 8000 mega transfer versus the 6400 mega transfer. Also worth noting is off the data is that the base performance of the CPU seems on par across ASRock, ASUS, and MSI, but slightly lower lower on Gigabyte / AORUS motherboards. Now, more testing is needed, of course, but it's an interesting trend nonetheless, and let us know in the comments if you want us to do some additional digging here. Well, that's it for this video. We walk you through a step-by-step guide on how to do this on every motherboard manufacturer. We showed you the performance, and now you have everything you need to enable the Intel Core Ultra 200S boost on your favorite Z890 motherboard. Of course, your mileage may vary. Remember, here's what Intel's saying, up to 16%. We didn't see anywhere near that, but we did see up to 10% at one point in time. And it's all gonna be dependent on the board and the chip, and of course, what applications and games you're using as well. Now it's time to know what you think. Was there anything that we missed in this video? Was there something in the guide that we actually didn't show you? Did you wanna see some more data? And if so, what specific data would you be looking for? And the last and biggest question, are you actually going to turn on Core Ultra 200S Boost? I'd love to know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this, either here on Robeytech or over at Robeytech Live. And if you want to continue the conversation, you want to talk more about the performance or what else you could do, or maybe you're just lost in one place, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to meet other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff and ask questions about stuff just like this. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us at Robeytech on all your favorite social media platforms. Thank you so much for making it this far, and I want to say a huge thank you for sticking with me throughout this video, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one.